I filled up these three containers full of crushed aluminium cans. And then I used a $250 furnace just like this one to turn those crushed aluminium cans into fistfuls of ingots just like this one. But of course it didn't come without its problems. My name's James Mayer and today we're melting down metal. As I mentioned, I bought this metal melting furnace off eBay for around $250. But the first problem was that I bought it in November and it arrived right at the start of summer, so because of fire restrictions I couldn't use it. By the time autumn came around I was going to give it a go, but as I was testing for leaks I found out the regulator was leaking. So I messaged the seller and they sent me a new one. A few weeks later that one arrived, but I had a newer style of connector that didn't fit my gas bottle. So I bought a new gas bottle. Luckily that screwed on, but as I was attaching the gas line to the burner I accidentally broke it off. So another few weeks go by and a new burner has arrived, but it's completely different style. The flare bit at the end wouldn't fit in the foundry, so I got rid of that and made a new one. Just as I thought I was ready to go, I found out that the thread on this burner is for the US style and does not fit the Australian gas bottles. So I ordered an adapter and when that arrived I could screw on the gas line and we were finally good to go after about 6 months or so of waiting. When setting up the foundry, the first thing you want to do is place the furnace on something hard and non-flammable like these blocks. Next, you need to get the gas bottle and mine's just a normal barbecue one. Screw the regulator side into the gas bottle. Then feed the burner tube inside the furnace. It doesn't need to go in too far, but once it's in, just snug it up with this top bolt. You may think it's ready to start burning, but you'd be wrong. We first must do a leak test on all the gas connections. So get some soapy water and splash plenty of it around each of the connectors. When you have enough on there, turn the gas on and inspect around to see if there's any bubbles. If not, we can then move on. Make sure the gas valve is turned off at this point, then cover the area in soapy water. Turn on the gas bottle again and the regulator this time too. Once again, give it a test to see if there's any bubbles. The first time I did this test, I did find some bubbles, so I added some gas PTFE tape to this connection, and that fixed it right up. Next, turn this connection on and test if you can hear any gas coming out. Perfect. It's time to light it up, and you can use a blowtorch if you like, but I just like to light a bit of paper and put it in the furnace. Then I turn the gas bottle on slowly until it ignites. Once it's ignited, I'll carefully adjust the gas pressure until I see a bright blue flame. I like to close the lid for a few minutes to quickly heat it up, and then I can put on my safety gear and lower the crucible in. If this is your first time using a new crucible, you'll have to heat up to about 500 degrees Celsius for about 5 minutes, then take it out and let it cool down slowly by itself. But mine is fine, so back in it goes. Here is just some of the aluminium cans that I'll be melting. Once you start throwing cans in, after a few seconds you'll see them burst into flames, and this is all the coating on the outside just burning off. Then it will melt into a nice little puddle of aluminium. I like to throw a few cans in at a time, then close the lid for a few seconds, and you'll see a bunch of flames shoot out the top, and then you can compress it all down with the tongs and load more in. The way I do it is to keep loading cans in until you have a nice pool of molten aluminium. The only problem with melting aluminium cans is that there is so much slag that comes off and needs to be scraped at the top before you can pour. When it's time to pour, I turn off the foundry and grab the crucible with the tongs. There are special tongs you can buy just for this, but these ones will do for now. I'm using a muffin tray to make these little ingots ready for remelting. The tray catches fire and lets out a horrible smell, and that's just because the non-stick coating is burning off, but this will be the only time it does that. After a few minutes, you can see that the aluminium has cooled down quite a bit considering the melting point of aluminium is 660 degrees Celsius. However, these are still hot enough that when we quench them in a bucket of water, they bring the water to an instant boil. These two ingots took about 60 cans and weigh about 200 grams each, which is pretty impressive. Now I just have to melt down a lot more cans. After all the containers are melted down, we can do a weigh up, and I'm weighing in small groups and adding up at the end. The total weight for everything is about 4.6 kilos of pure aluminium, which is pretty good for what we got. I have 3 bars, which on average weigh about 300 grams each, and 17 cupcake style ingots, which on average weigh about 200 grams each. I'm super impressed with this metal foundry, and it takes no time at all to heat up and melt down aluminium. All these ingots will go towards casting shapes and objects, which I'll do in future projects, so subscribe and stay tuned for that one. But with all that done, for now there is only one thing left to do. And that's to start all over again. Thanks for watching.